Hello, I'm Philippe from Sinrumbo. Thank you for joining me. Today I would like to say a big thank you to all of you who have been watching my videos, subscribing, liking, commenting. It's something very unexpected for me. The channel has now over 200 subscribers, and the video, the inside tour of the camper truck, has over 50,000 views, so I never planned for this. And please do comment and leave me suggestions, ideas, things you would like me to cover in future videos. That's always welcome. And if you're new to the channel, please click the logo in the right bottom corner. You can do this at any time, and that will allow you to subscribe. So thank you very much. Today we're taking a drive to the mountains, up to 3,000 meters of altitude, about 10,000 feet, to go hiking, but also to test the electrical system with the new fridge and a 12 volt hack that I just did. Up to this point, I haven't been quite satisfied with the electrical system, the fridge operation, and the charging of the home battery. For a few years now, vehicles have been coming out with what they call a variable voltage alternator, and rather than the alternator putting out a fixed voltage like it used to, now the voltage is controlled by the electronic control module onboard the vehicle, and the voltage is varied depending on the driving condition, state of charge of the battery, and that causes all sorts of problems for people who install a second battery on the vehicle. This hack returns the alternator to its fixed voltage mode, and if it works as advertised, I'll let you know. I'll do a complete video on the electrical system and everything I've learned along the way. Alright, so I want to take the opportunity of this day out, beautiful day out, to give you an update on the big adventure of the year, the 2019 adventure for Sinrumbo, and that's the trip to Peru and Bolivia planned for mid-October until early December. The idea is to, from Mendoza, Argentina, to cross into Chile, and then head up along the Pacific coast of Chile to the desert of Atacama, which is a high altitude, very dry place. I think it's one of the driest places on Earth. Sometimes for years it doesn't receive any rain or moisture at all. Some amazing landscapes there. And from there we'll cross into Bolivia. High altitude again, the lowest is about 3,600 meters, that's 10,000 feet, up to 16,000 feet, so it's going to be a challenge for the truck, a challenge for us, very remote, no towns, no nothing. So a few days there, then we cross back into Chile, go back down to the coast, so major altitude change. Then we go to Peru, to Cusco. We'll leave the truck parked for probably about a week while we go and do the Machu Picchu and visit the area, the town of Cusco. Then drive south to Puno and Lake Titicaca for a day or two. And then re-enter Bolivia, and there we're going to be heading for the Saltar de Uyuni, a huge dry salt lake. It's so big, so flat, and so white that NASA uses it as a reflector to calibrate the altitude of the GPS satellites. So it's a place that is a challenge for navigation because there's no road and it's all white and it all looks the same, very disorienting. And the goal is to drive to an island that's in the middle. There's a few islands, but to one of the islands in the middle, spend a day, maybe a night there, and just breathtaking landscapes. From there, we'll exit to the town of Uni, which is nothing special, but it's a good place to wash the salt off the truck, refuel, get some food, and then we'll head back down to Argentina, where for me, I think the main attraction is a place that's called Piedras Gomez. It's a huge area of white rocks, very, very unreal, very weird. Pumice rocks, and it's a volcanic area. It's really weird, so we'll spend a couple of days there and then slowly make our way home to Mendoza. So about 10,000 kilometers for the whole loop, and 5-6 weeks more or less in the road. I'm gonna show you a little bit of this area. It's a gorgeous day, like typical day in Mendoza in the winter. It's cold, but the sun is nice and warm. Sky is pure blue, there's not a single cloud around. A little bit of snow, so we'll see how it goes getting to where we want to get. But let me show you a few details.